Today, each of us has a water pipe. And not so long ago, people were praying to have the sacred spring, this spring. And there is such a spring in Azov. It is cared, it is looked after. Good causes like the spring make people pure and better. For the town Azov, more than 100 years ago, the picturesque spring of charity became a woman called Larisa Vasilievna Timmerman. It was an accidental case that we applied to that time and in general to the story of that name. It happened occasionally. And it began since the year 1991 during the repair and reconstructive works on the territory of the kindergarten number 1 in the town Azov. When the workers discovered some well-filed surface of a big stone, upon the words of one of the workers. And what surprises those who found it, and then also surprised us, the workers of the museum, is that there was an inscription. The Azov Town Society is grateful to the general philanthropist Larisa Vasilievna Timmerman. Even there was a street in honor of this woman in the town Azov. Once she applied to the town authorities, asking them to accept her house and her villa as a donation. They were located in the same place where nowadays the Azov orphanage is staying. A little bit later, Larisa Vasilievna bespoke her conditions. If the authorities would have accepted that donation, then she asked to organize the medical institutions on the territory of her house and of her villa. It means the municipal hospital, the clinic, and the poor house. The poor house, in the modern language, is the old people's home, and home for lonely people. It means what is desired by God. And in the year 1903, Larisa Vasilievna wrote the official last will and did the definite instruction. I cannot say what she left for her relatives, but she left much for the town of Azov. Larisa Vasilievna divided her capital in four parts, with the interest of the first part, the maintenance of the three beds in the villa of Larisa Vasilievna Timmerman should be paid. With the interest of the second part, the taxes into the treasury to maintain all the sick people in the hospital should be paid. The interest from the third part of the capital was used for the sick people in the special barrack isolation ward, and also to fight with the poverty. The money was given out to the poor people during the great Christian holidays. Interest from the fourth part of the capital was used to pay the scholarship of two students in the feminine high school. The part of money was left to buy one more place for villa, where the second parishional feminine college should be built. The authorities bought the land, but they did not manage to build it. On the 2nd of April of 1905, Larisa Vasilievna Timmerman died. Her decease happened in Kiev. Her last confession was taken by the priest of the St. Lipetsk Church in the city of Kiev, the priest Ishimitsky. On the 7th of April, the coffin with the corpse of Timmerman was fetched to Azov, because she wanted to be buried here, in our town. The coffin with the corpse of the deceased or mother benefactress, as she was called, was installed in the building erected on her money, in the hall of the Azov Feminine High School. Due to what the eyewitnesses described, from that very building up to the church, the road was covered with the carpets and the natural flowers. And precisely following this way, the people were carrying it. The coffin with the corpse of Larisa Vasilievna Timmerman, changing each other in that short period of road. If to give the permission to reinter or to restore the Assumption Cathedral, it will be better looking and worthy. Because we step with our feet nowadays not the half, but the whole town is stepping this place, and even not thinking, the bones of whom are lying here. These are the forgotten names. If to remember them, it would be a great deal for the town. Father, how was built the regimental church of Azov, Mother of God? Our church was also built by the whole town, by the whole world. We can say it, yes? In the construction of our church, even the kindergartens participated. They played performances and gathered money and brought all the money up to the kopeck. The concerts were organized and the donations on the factories were gathered. Well, all people tried to participate in the building of the church, and it is continued like that. It is a good tradition. How does the parish live today? The parish is a live organism. Surely it lives. It can't be in another way. We participate in different projects, social projects. Our parish opens the social department. In the St. Nicholas Church, in the west part of the town, the clothes are given out to the poor people. If now you go around the church, you can see that there the missionary center is started to build. It is a Sunday school. It is a whole program which is elaborated for the spiritual and moral education of children. It is visited by the children who are sick with ICP and the SANI children. The Down syndrome suffers. The professionals also work with them. There will be the reading rooms. It will be an accessible missionary center. Ivanovna, what do the classes with special children give personally to you? You know, it is already the part of my life. Well, how to say? First of all, for me it is a great joy, because when I see the results of my labor and I understand that in reality it is a good cause. Maybe we ourselves did not think it would be like this. We just wanted to try to do it. Only this. And then to watch the result. And now I just don't imagine that I can work without them, that these children will not be here. Because they are good. You can see what Slavik is. Well, he came late. And the life of Slavik changed after he started to study here. Well, before we started to study, it is possible to say we did not live, because really it was just an existence. We were as if in the darkness, and he himself did not understand anything. What he is, what for he is. Only after the classes our new birth happened. He acquired the feeling of dignity. He has a character now. Now he himself chooses what he wants, what he needs. It means he can manage his desires somehow. He felt himself to be a human being. It is the most important. Now he can be offended. He can be preoccupied. And earlier there was nothing of it. He did not have any emotions, any feelings at all. He even could not cry. He did not cry at all. When I saw that he was offended, that he was hurt, he cried. You will not believe, I was so glad. Because earlier we did not know this feeling. This is precisely music. And the music pushes to all the rest. The social projects of Azov Municipal Charity Fund, Budushie Detim, Future for the Children, will teach the alphabet of charity. The special children, the parents, the teachers, the volunteers are united for the main aim – to see in each person the God's creature. Well, if someone doesn't like to watch how we jingle out of time, well, let him not watch. And who wants will be glad, just will be glad, and will have a smile. I hope we'll bring the joy, even if not all results good, it does not matter. The most important thing is that they are all together, and in general, I think they can be taught, only it is a laborious work, and not each one will want to do it, because it is very difficult, and secondly, people do not see any development, and what development can be? We are not going to gain any awards or to be musicians. I suppose no one of us has such plans. Well, why can't our children study the music while other children are studying it? Why not? They all can, because we love them and we comprehend them. Also the sponsors appear, people who are not indifferent, who have the generous hearts, and these hearts can embrace our children. Well, we hope that our children will not feel themselves so invalids. Here they are glad, they laugh, they play and feel love. And what is the freedom? And do you have it? Many people think, watching me, that I am in the pushchair and that I am not a free person. But it is not the truth. Now I finished the 11th class. My notes are 4 and 5. Today I have passed the test work on Russian language to enter the college. And I also practice the dances. You dedicated many years of your life to the professional dance, and now you dedicate much time of your creative life to the dances with the invalid pushchairs. You teach the children to move. And what do they teach you? I think that they teach me more comprehension, charity, and paying attention on the more difficult problems in our life. You work with special children. About what future do you dream for the children? First of all, to work hard. Because the dances on the pushchairs are some kind of rehabilitation for them. Secondly, the integration of them into the society, for the society to accept them as they are. And maybe in the future they will prove they do not differ from the rest of our children. Children, I want to tell you one very interesting story about this small house. It was 5 years ago. Once we were sitting with one honest man, the benefactor of the churches of Rostov Epochy. It was absolutely occasional. We were just sitting and chatting, and we started to speak about Vysochino, about the church, and he said, let's go, let's see, and it was in winter. We came in winter, but we even did not know that there lived a gypsy woman with 3 children. Her husband was in the jail, and she, as she could, was living there. There, 2 women lived, 2 mothers, one had a baby, and the other. When one had the milk, she was feeding, the gypsy woman was feeding the Russian baby. When the Russian woman had the milk, she was feeding the gypsy baby. So they lived there like 2 sisters in that church, because they had no other place to live in. The head of Vysochino let them live there. So we came there with that man, and that woman who was living there, she became ill and she was in the hospital. And the oldest son was starving much. You know, when we entered, we were in stupor. It was cold, and the child was lying already done blue. We asked, where is your mother? And he answered, the mother is in the hospital, the youngest became ill, And your father?
My father is in jail.
So the head of the village sheltered them, and thanks to God.
So we knew in what hospital she was, and we went there. And we bought the products for him, but asked him not to eat much. We fetched the wood. And when we came to his mother in the hospital, before our arrival, she has said, God, probably I am a big sinner, so you left me. And when we came, when we found her, she said, God heard me. And we all started to cry. You see, the person was in the last stage of despair. She already said that she was so big sinner that God left her. And then I baptized the child, and her older brother appeared and took her, and thanks to God she lives. This is a small story, but very interesting. Shows how God leads. We even did not think. We just wanted to watch the church. The man said that he wanted to watch the church in Vysochino. And we came there precisely in the moment we were needed. You see that God always leads when the people are in the last stage of despair and when there is only one hope upon God. God helps to all. To Gypsy people, to Korean people, to Russians, to all. He does not have the nations. The God is one for all. The translation is done and read by Marina Yufreva. Production by the creative group Cool Show, Azov, Russia, 2011-2012.